If you're an employee or an entrepreneur, running your own business has a challenge that comes along, which is being productive and organized at the same time. In this video, I'm totally excited to share and take a deep dive into a tool called Taskade to simplify your life and enable your team to get work done faster and smarter anywhere.
All right, what is Taskade? It's a free software, but don't underestimate its value. It's a productivity app, a to-do list app, week planner, project tracker, collaborative internal video chat app, all combined. I have been using it for quite some time and I must say that it is mighty impressive.
From my point of view, this tool is a golden nugget for freelancers, students to organize their studies, individuals to organize their thoughts, and remote teams to collaborate in real time with video chat and so much more.
Comparing with other similar apps, I would like to think of Taskade as more of a planner with all ideas and statuses in one place. With abilities to share and collaborate with others while organizing tasks by putting them on a calendar to get them done. It's more than a simple to-do list and has quite a lot of the same things as a Notion app and what we saw on my ClickUp demo video as well. It's also more in scope and ease of use than what Trello offers in my opinion. The free version of Taskade includes unlimited file storage, unlimited tasks, collaborators, unlimited workspaces and subspaces, unlimited projects, and all the essential features unlocked, which is really generous. You can download their apps from this link here. We also have the option to upgrade to Taskade Unlimited, which includes advanced features and customizations, reporting, revision history, and priority support. By the way, Taskade has got raving reviews already and was awarded App of the Day on the Apple's App Store. Please use the links given below in the description to sign up for Taskade. They also agreed to offer a free 1-year upgrade to their paid plan if you're interested. And to get that, simply email the Taskade team at taskade.com/contact or email them at support@taskade.com and just mention my channel, Tech Library TV. And they'll offer you a free 1-year upgrade to their paid plan.
All right, before we begin the demo, please do me a favor and hit the like button.
First, let's go over the basics of their user interface and see how Taskade can help us in boosting our organized productivity. After you sign up, go ahead and create a new workspace. As you can see, it has got an aesthetic simple look and feel with pretty colors. Workspace is a collection of projects. You can create a new workspace by clicking on this plus icon. Just give it a name and choose a color of your choice and click this button, new workspace. Next, Taskade immediately asks us if we want to invite any other team member to work with. If you have none, I would say you can skip this step by clicking outside. If you want to invite someone, you can do so by entering their email address here and choose the level of access between an editor or just a viewer. A viewer can only comment and chat in projects but cannot create or edit projects and templates, whereas an editor has these options but just cannot manage the workspace level settings. You could also just click on this tab and simply copy this invite link to share with others through email or any other sharing apps. By inviting others to join the workspace, you can collaborate together on multiple projects all in real time. Taskade workspaces are private by default, and other users can only get access to your workspace if they are invited by you or someone already in the workspace. What's best is that if you would like a private space for yourself within a shared workspace, you can create new workspaces for free or create a subspace inside it for yourself. A workspace and a subspace act the same way. The only major difference between a workspace and a subspace is that a subspace is built under a workspace when you upgrade it. Alright, now we created a new workspace, but it's nothing without any projects in it. So let's create a new project within this workspace. Speaking of which, we have three options to create a new project. One, we can start from a blank project. Two, import it from Trello. Or three, simply create from an existing template and we can even make them reusable. This is currently empty because I haven't created any templates yet. They also have more importing options planned in the near future, as we can see from here. After we click on the blank project, it gives us a set of templates to choose from on the top. We can also change the views of a project within our workspace like origami from this drop-down list. We can visualize each project via multiple views: list view, board view, an action view, a mind map view, and an org chart view. There could be more views available depending on when you are watching this video, but for now I got these 5 beautiful views available. We'll see these in detail in a few minutes. You can use Taskade for creating weekly meeting agendas, planners, team meetings, project outlines, product roadmaps, and much more. For inspiration, try out their free templates from here, taskade.com/templates, which offers a variety of ready-to-import templates for workflow automation. It could be for Scrum meetings, task trackers, meeting notes, and even grocery shopping lists. All these templates are neatly organized into various categories that you can navigate from this list here. What's great is that you can even create your own template and automate your workflows. One of the best features is that you could make use of handy filters to organize tasks, notes, and then simply click on them to filter by that tag. Working with teams, just remember that you could tag someone by using the @ symbol. Before we proceed further, let's look at a couple of housekeeping things. This profile icon gives us all the options and settings to change the dark mode, manage billing, and to log out of our Taskade account. The background can be changed by clicking on this icon on the bottom left corner and by choosing a color or an image. You could also upload a custom image to set as the background. This space is for the chat and the calls options. If you're just starting out, this get started calls you for attention. But in this case, since we are here to create a blank project, that's what is blinking now for our attention, clicking on which creates a blank project without any template items. This hamburger icon has options to see our own tasks, recently added tasks, overall activity in the workspace, our start items, and more. If you're working with teams, just make sure that you make use of this video calling feature, which is really handy, wherein you can take notes and files and do much more with this feature. Now, to create a new project, I'm going to click on this weekly planner and add a few sample goals. These are draggable, so we can position them anywhere by dragging and dropping. We can also change the format of these tasks. To create a subtask, simply indent it by hitting the tab key. There are more options like assigning it to a member, fixing a due date to complete, attach a file, add to calendar, set priority, colors, labels, and a few other options. We can create tags to organize different projects and name them whatever you want. These become more handy after we create a lot of projects. One of the great features is Taskade's collab feature, where we can chat or have a video call easily with other team members. Leave comments there and share files right from this dashboard. These video calls can also be recorded. Now let me minimize this chat window first to get some extra space. Okay, now let's change this list view into a board view. One thing to note here is to understand how to write goals and not to confuse them with tasks. More often than not, we should write SMART goals that are specific, realistic, achievable. So in this context, they are doable within a week. Tasks can then be our broken down action items that are smaller and baby steps towards achieving those weekly goals. That's how I usually do my goal setting and then have them broken down into actionable tasks. It's really important we make this distinction while writing down our goals versus tasks. Anyway, choose the view that suits your needs. I'm going to next try this action view and see what it does. Okay, so this view resembles the older notebook view I feel so, and with ruled lines running across tasks. Use it to print if you need it and paste it or pin to your action boards. More helpful for people. I think these are more helpful for people who love physically ticking off tasks when complete. Of course, this also lets you tick off on the screen itself. But so you have that the notebook view, which is called as the action view. Next, mind map view. This displays a nested structure view, while retaining all the editing options we saw in the other views. Especially helpful and useful if you have a large monitor and want to keep this board displayed for monitoring purposes. Maybe you have a team where you're all sitting together and you have a large monitor. You can easily place this for monitoring your task progress. You can also just hit the tab key and enter to add cascading subtasks. Lastly, we have the org chart view. That's not immediately useful tested it for this kind of content, but quite handy if you really want to have a hierarchical view of your tasks like a traditional flowchart. Well, one thing you may have noticed is a star on these areas, which allows us to make any of these views as our default view. Although I love mind maps, for now I'll keep the list view as the default view to keep things simple for this demo. And by the way, if you need to quickly perform a search operation to find any specific task after you create a bunch of them, simply hit Ctrl F keyboard shortcut to start searching for the tasks you need. Overall, I tested with almost all its variations and I'm mighty pleased with its syncing abilities, which is almost real time. So in my opinion, this is an amazing productivity tool and it was a pleasure to use the tool on all the platforms. I just had a few observations. These could be changed by the time you even watch this video, but I wanted to mention them anyway. The one thing I found is we cannot click to scroll horizontally across this board view as we could do in Trello, but there is this scroll bar which solves the purpose. And alternatively, we can also hold down the shift key while scrolling to view the different lists in this board view. The list view is available in the Android app. When I tested it on my phone at the time of making this video, the other views are all in the pipeline and will be released in the near future. And lastly, Taskade is great for a team of any size. However, they do recommend that having up to 10 participants maximum per project would be optimal at this time, especially when it comes to video calling feature. For Workspace members and project collaborators, they do allow unlimited users. So that being said, this is definitely a great software for freelancers, students, developers, artists, homemakers, and any individual or focused small teams. As a reminder, please use the given links in my video description. If you're interested to give the premium features a try, get them free for 1 year by emailing Taskade team via this page and just mention my channel name. Thanks so much for watching and please hit that like button if you enjoyed and learned something from my review. Bye.